coming up in this Brightline Construction Update. This update looks at the progress on the right-of-way around the Interstate 95, State Road 528 Interchange, in Cocoa, Florida, along with the associated realignment of State Road 528 to make way for the tracks. We'll start with an overview of the site, then look closer at some of the specific details. I'm currently flying north with State Road 528 in front. The large pile of dirt is part of the realignment of the road to make way for Brightline's tracks. The pile is easily 30 to 40 feet tall. Turning west now, the curved shape in the trench on the right is the floor of the tunnel that the tracks will pass through to pass under the 528. These curved concrete shapes are what will actually form the tunnel when it is assembled. Since the new road is being built around the tunnel, crews can actually build the tunnel first, then fill the dirt around it to finish the road. Continuing west, you can see the ramp the tracks will take to go over Interstate 95. The ramp itself is close to being complete, and it's just waiting on the tunnel pieces to be moved so that area can be built up. Headed back east, it is possible to see the gentle curve the right-of-way takes as it goes under the future 528 alignment to ride along the northern edge of the road, east toward the Cocoa Curve and Tunnel. As for why the route follows the northern edge of the 528 between here and the Cocoa Tunnel is quite simple. There's a significant amount of development on the southern side, including parts of several residential neighborhoods that would have to be acquired and removed to make room for the tracks. 528 right-of-way was already wider on the north side, so there is more room to add the tracks and still not be in the way of future road widening projects as well. The shape of the future lanes on the new alignment is starting to be able to be seen here. On the north side of the road is the massive borrow pit providing the dirt for the realignment of the 528 and the Brightline right-of-way. Dump trucks pick up dirt from the pits and bring them to the conveyor belt that was built across the 528. Once moved across the road, the dirt is piled up until more trucks pick it up and move it to where it is needed. The borrow pit will eventually become a massive lake. An example of a borrow pit reclamation can be seen by the lake in the top left corner. Over at the tunnel location, crews have been working on the foundation and the footers that will support the tunnel pieces that I previously showed piled up. The black and blue tarps are covering the latest concrete pour that happened a couple days earlier. Over by this crane are the forms crews are using to build the tunnel pieces. Crews put together these forms along with rebar inside and pour in concrete. After the concrete sets, they take apart the forms to remove the newly completed pieces, then repeat the process until all the pieces are complete. Here is another, closer look at the foundation. Heading back to the ramp for the bridge over Interstate 95, the large lake on this side, as well as the smaller one on the far side, were formed during this project, acting as borrow pits for the ramp. Now on the west side of 95, you can see the completed bridge supports between the lanes of traffic. Those supports are now complete, but work is still necessary on each side of the road on the header supports where the individual pilings are still visible. Headed west now, the tracks will be on top of this embankment between the interstate and the Pine Street Bridge. It is close to being complete. With the relatively short distance between the interstate and Pine Street, it did not make sense to change the elevation of the tracks just to go back up again. The pilings for the bridge over Pine Street are still visible as well. This embankment, along with the rest of the right-of-way being built for Brightline to Orlando, will be wide enough to hold double track. With a shorter distance between the road and embankment here, crews built up a retaining wall so the size of the embankment could be reduced on this side. Looking straight down on the pilings, you can see that they are hollow, which allows rebar and concrete to be poured in when creating the headers, creating a unified, solid structure. Heading about a mile west of the interchange provides a view of the right-of-way as it heads west to Orlando alongside the 528. You can see the Interstate 95 interchange in the distance. Crews have been working between here and Pine Street to build up the ramp to that bridge. Looking west again, you can see the long straight segment of the right-of-way down to where it will curve left across the St. John's River. This area only recently started seeing regular work. Thanks for watching. Be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. Also check out my social media pages.